So Coach Theodore Tapa Whitmore, who scored 2 goals in the World Cup back in 1998 when we beat Japan 2-1, has signed a 4-year contract with the Jamaica Football Federation. You would have heard the story. He was on again, off again, and he did not like what they were offering before, and he resigned, and he's back now. And the good news is that he has a 4-year contract, which is not a surprise because they go the World Cup year, so you're hired to take the team to the next World Cup. And if you don't, then you probably will be fired. So that's the 4-year is not a surprise. And I certainly wish him all the very, very, very best.
Yes.
He's in charge 16 games since he came back in 2016. And he's won 7 and he's tied 4. So he's only lost 5 out of 16, which is good stuff. And he's was a good player and he's a good coach. So wish him all the very, very best. He asked the GFF not to disclose his salary.
Hey, I hear you, brother.
I don't have no problem with that at all. And now we move on. So he's the head coach. They've named an under-23 coach, Donovan Ducky, which is the Olympic team. And things are starting to move. So again, good luck, Bridget.
Yes, good
luck. What's the next one?
When's the next World Cup after this one?
2022.
2022.
In Qatar, I think.
In Qatar?
Yeah. Qatar, right?
Let's go, Neville. Let's plan to go. I know you don't like to fly late.
Yeah, you go and bring back something.
I'm going to pick up the reggae boys right now. We've been following and hearing this story on TVJ News. Well-known real estate attorney Jennifer Misato was recently arrested following allegations that she tried to sell properties owned by a church without the owner's consent. It's currently under investigation, and she has received bail alongside... let me tell you, co-accused 72-year-old Beverly Barakat, who's also a real estate broker. Granted bail in the sums of $800,000
and
$50,000 respectively.
Misato is charged with 2 counts of forgery. Two counts of uttering forged documents, conspiracy to defraud, causing money to be paid out by forged documents, and money laundering. While Barakat is charged with conspiracy to defraud. They say she reportedly forged the signature of the trustee along with the property owner's stamp and letterhead to facilitate the fraudulent transaction and collected $270,000 as down payment from the buyer.
Well, the properties were sold for $232 million, and we are hearing that Misato has returned $190,000 to the purchaser and plans to return the balance.
$190,000?
Yeah, of the... 200 and something.
$232 million, yes.
That's the cost of the property. But remember, Misato didn't receive that. That she received $270,000 as a down payment and has returned $190,000.
U.S.
Yes, let me guess. Let's just state.
That's what I
yes, U.S. Straight. Dollars. Let me get that right. Anyway, as it relates to Barakat, Lawson said this is the... clerk of the court, that Lawson said that the prosecution has documents to show that she contacted the purchaser about the sale of the properties and that she did not carry out her due diligence before the property was put up for sale. So in respect to Barakat, the only condition was for her to get 1 surety as it relates to the bail. And the judge, after announcing that the bail amount was $50,000, quickly explained that the amount was arrived at because she did not hear any arguments that Barakat had actively participated in the alleged fraud. Judge Ellis also said that a breach of due diligence does not justify criminal sanction. Both women are to return to court on July 3.
All right, we move
on.
Kim Jong-un. He's called off a high-level meeting with South Korea, apparently, and he's threatened to scrap the summit next month between President Donald Trump and himself. That should be in Indonesia, I think. And this is because he says there are military exercises between South Korea and the United States. It says they are invading his space. So he says he doesn't want that. And if the United States, they don't pull back, he's not going to be meeting Donald Trump at all. So they were to meet at a border village to discuss how to implement their leaders' recent arrangements. This is North and South Korea, to reduce military tensions along with heavily fortified border and improve their overall ties. Pyongyang has no interest in a summit with Washington if it's going to be a one-sided affair where it's pressured to give up its nukes, says Kim Jong-un. State Department said Kim had previously indicated he understood the need and purpose of the U.S. continuing its long-planned exercises with South Korea. And the United States have said we will continue to go ahead and plan the meeting between President Trump and Kim Jong-un. So, sure we'll hear more about that.
Wow.
All right.
North and South Korea ever get together? That,
yeah, well,
it looked hopeful at one point.
Yeah.
But
still might be.
It still might be.
Certainly hope.
So much going on with Trump.
Yeah.
So much going on.
Still hope that it happens. All right. I got a couple of birthdays.
Thinking about Jerusalem right now and the embassy and all of these things going on. What else is up, Mr. Bell? I know you're about to get ready for the birthdays.
Yeah.
Can I just say a very important hot topic, which is something that I believe that we need to have a lot more conversations. That is on the front page of the Gleaner. We're talking about time to confront Britain on reparation. Just follow Professor Vereen Shepherd, and it's, you know, with everything that we saw happening with the Windrush generation, it's a time for reparation. It's a time for Britain to talk up, to apologize, and look at our 10-point plan. And I want to congratulate the Jamaican government's National Council on Reparation for the move that they are making to hold Britain accountable, and let's see how it will benefit us who are the living generation of the enslaved that has never been compensated for the injustice. So let's right the wrong. Front page of the Gleaner, read it. Pay up now. All right, that's what's hot.
All right. Here's Romario Jones. This is a former national youth player and Manning Cup winner. Romario Jones' birthday was yesterday. Obviously, he wasn't here yesterday. Hope you had a great one, son. I know he's on scholarship abroad. And I hope you had a brilliant day. And I wish you many, many more.
Mm-hmm.
Happy birthday to the great Ferron's daughter. Her name is Keon Abigail Tyrrell.
What?
There she is. She goes to Excelsior. And greetings coming from your mom, Peaches, your dad, Basil. Basil Ferron, and your sister Camille, and hope you have a brilliant, brilliant day. Your dad says he
That's
loves
Ferron's
you.
Ferron's daughter?
Yeah, like crazy.
Ferron!
There you go.
He makes sweet picnic.
This lady is Janet Latchy. Miss Jan, I hope you have a great day today. Happy birthday from your daughter, Sudine, from your niece, Lachelle, and the rest of the family, from us here.
Mm-hmm.
Have a brilliant day, and I wish you so many, many more.
Boy, I have so many, and I'm going to get into it. This is a happy belated birthday to Denshar Mitchell Burrows from your form teacher, Mr. Claire, and your classmates. All right, let me just show her off because Neville does it very well, and I need to follow suit. Denshar, happy birthday, right, from your form teacher and your classmates. That's her. Yep, zoom in. Lovely camera work right there. Snap it. Boom. Oh, I love it. You know I love being behind the camera as well. I have another birthday coming from my Instagram friend, Tanisha. And Tanisha, big up yourself. Happy birthday to her brother, Marlon Bobby, a.k.a. Bobby. Yeah, happy birthday from Tanisha Brown and family. We also have another one coming here, an 87-year-old diamond in this world. It is Vera Blanche Miller, Denise Isis Miller's mom. Let's show her off. Because you know I love the elders. Yes.
There she is.
Mashallah, Kati.
There she is. Happy
You know, that's going to be me and you one day, just like 80-something, 90-something. That's so nice. Like, I just, boy, we really need to respect our elders.
Me and make you?
Well, you get there a little bit before me, but I'll be there too one day. And it's just beautiful. I love old people. I mean, I say wise people, I should say. I know I have another one that came in, but I know that my producer is probably going to cut me because she's very feisty like that. When the time comes, she's like, yo, that's it. We're going to the
you
other birthday.
Big up so nice.
Yeah, man, but feisty is good because I'm feisty too. I can't find it though. I'm sorry. Whoever sent me via email. Oh, Ajani's birthday.
Who is Ajani?
Pleasant evening to you, lady. Oh, yes. Birthday greetings to her son. He's 12. One and only
Who's
child,
son?
Me no know, Neshi Campbell's picnic, who's 12. And he attends a one-way prep school, preparatory school, coming from the mom. Aisha, not Neshi. Neshi had the email. Aisha Campbell. Yeah, man, I'm going to show him.
I'm confused.
Yeah, see me here. Happy birthday, darling. You know Auntie Empress loves children.
I'm confused.
So I cannot miss this one. There he is. There you go, my darling, Johnny. Happy birthday, darling. What happened to your aunt? Oh, oops, all right. That's the picture mommy sent. Happy birthday.
Again.